Saturday morning and it's time to go. One day these could be the days, but who could have known? Loading in the back of a pickup truck, riding with the boys and pushing the luck, singing songs loud on the way to the game.
Coach Chapman, a lot of you guys always ask me, how do you make puppy chow? So I decided to put this little thing up on the web. My wife and I are going to be showing you how we make puppy chow. First, we start off with the awesome Chex Mix rice cereal. Now, you can buy the expensive stuff or the cheap stuff. I'm a cheapskate because I'm a teacher. So this is what we got. We got 10 boxes of Chex Mix. Then we come over here and we have 10 bags of semi-sweet chocolate chips. You need one bag for every box of cereal. After that, we have powdered sugar. You just need a whole bunch depending on how much sugar you want to use. We got 3 large bags here and a whole bunch of peanut butter. Alright, first things first is to get 1 cup of peanut butter. So for every box of cereal, you need a cup of peanut butter. And it doesn't have to be exact, but it is extremely messy. So, scoop this off until you get to about a cup. I think you can see a cup on there. That's about right. Then what we do is put in a big glass bowl, microwavable bowl, as best you can. And then after that, you mix in 1 full bag of chips. So it's 1 pound of chips. Pour this in there. There we go. Now, what you're gonna do first is you're gonna put this in the microwave for 45 seconds. You don't want to put it in there for too long because it'll burn and it won't taste good. So you put it in there for 45 seconds and then you stir it. Then another 45 seconds and stir it again. Okay, this is after the first 45 seconds in the microwave, and as you can see, it's kind of melting, but you got to stir it up really, really good. And once you're through with that, make sure you get all the good stuff off the spoon. If it wants to come off. Then you're going to put it in there for another 45 seconds. Okay, this is after the second 45 seconds, and you can kind of see it's still not very runny, but after you stir it, then it becomes perfect. So this is right about where you want it. Looks kind of like the real thick syrup. You can't tell there's chocolate chips in it, and so you want to mix that up, and then we're on to the next. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to pour our cereal into a bowl. Now, I do not have a bowl big enough for one, so I use 2 very big bowls, but if you have one, you can do this in one bowl. So, empty about half and half, and once you're finished with that, you're going to take your melted chocolate chips and peanut butter, and you're going to pour this all over the cereal. So, doesn't really matter, you're going to get messy in this process, so you just want to make sure you get it at about half and half. So there's half for that side, and the rest over here. And it doesn't have to be exact. Okay, now it's time for the fun start. Okay, we got the cereal, and we got our chocolate and peanut butter melted poured in there. Now what you have to do is use your hands. So make sure your hands are clean, and you're gonna get messy, and you're just gonna mix it up as best you can, just constantly stirring it with your hands. Now, it's gonna be a little bit warm at first, so make sure you don't burn yourself, but you wanna do it really soft, and if you use a spoon, you'll just break all the cereal and it won't work right. So you wanna make sure you use your hands, and you wanna mix it and keep mixing it until it's completely consistent. So like if you look at it, you see some dry pieces, you don't want that. You wanna keep mixing it up until it's completely even. And it's nice and clean, see? Yummy. Funny thing is, you guys put this in your mouth. Okay, now we got this mixed up. You can kinda see what it looks like. It's real sticky, it's completely covered. And we have 2 regular brown paper bags that you get at a grocery store. I got them at Kroger. Make sure you use 2, because if not, you're going to make a huge mess because these get little bitty holes in them. So now what you're going to do is you're going to take powdered sugar and you're going to pour this in the bottom of it. So you don't have to pour a whole bunch, just enough to get the bottom of it covered. And then you're going to take this whole bowl and you're going to just dump it in there. Then we take more powdered sugar and pour it on top. More goodness. Okay? And then you have to make sure you roll the bags up separately. So you take the inside bag, fold it up, and then you take the outside bag. Now this is the fun part. You just take it and you're gonna shake it and turn it till it mixes completely. Okay. done shaking it, open it up, and I don't know if you can see in there very well, but that's about what it should look like, and you are good to go. So that is all it takes for Puppy Chow, and it's really, really cheap and a lot of fun. So thanks a lot, guys. Helping you guys, helping me, most importantly. But hope you guys enjoy this, because a lot of people are working hard for you. You guys deserve it. This is my awesome dog, Annabelle. Annabelle! Annie! Ooh. Anybody crazy out there today? Tank. He's big and lazy. What's up, Tank? Tank! I think he says good job, kids.